We're Naik and Kim, a Belgian couple who traveled the world for a year and a half before buying and converting this Ford Transit into a tiny house on wheels that we now live and travel in full time. After spending our first month of winter van life in the icy but beautiful Swedish Arctic Circle, a few days ago we drove to Switzerland to explore the Swiss Alps. One of the things we've really been looking forward to is trying that quintessential Swiss meal, traditional Swiss cheese fondue. Because of COVID, going to a local restaurant is not an option, but we have found an alternative that may be even better.
So Switzerland is currently in a near complete lockdown. Aside from the ski resorts, everything is closed. Restaurants, bars, non-essential shops, dorks, but nature is open.
So today we are going to prepare our own Swiss cheese fondue near a beautiful lake in the Swiss Alps.
There you go.
Thank you.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to Switzerland. We just spent the night here at the parking lot where you saw us in the previous video, and we were thinking that today was gonna be the day for our big excursion.
Thank you.
But it turns out today is probably not gonna be that day, because it's super, super cloudy and even snowy.
It doesn't look too great outside. I even cannot see across the lake. I can barely see the lake that's about 50 feet away. So yeah, the weather is a bit not too great today, but we're already going to start the preparation. Since we are in the mountains, weather changes very, very quickly. So, I mean, in a matter of an hour, it can also clear up a lot.
Fixing us some breakfast here, AKA some bread. Good old jar of peanut butter. Oh, we're running out apparently, so we need to buy some new peanut butter. Cave exploration. I swear, we have more stuff down here than we do in our upper cabins. But I was actually looking for this little fella, the table mount.
We are all good to go, converted into a table. Kim is putting away the table mounts. Hi, Kim. No, this is the right side of Kim. Just here. Back on the road again. Now, our plan for today might sound a little bit cheesy. But yeah, one of my favorite meals is actually cheese fondue, and of course, Switzerland is the birthplace of the cheese fondue. It's like the national dish. It's what it's most famous for, except for that they love money here and they have lots of banks. But
and tax cuts too.
Yeah, Kim used to be a tax lawyer. She knows all about it. Anyway, we are not that far off from some of the famous cheese regions here called Gruyère and Emmental. You probably heard of those cheeses. We're now heading to Emmental, to the cheese factory there. Cheese factory is closed, but the shop is open, so we're gonna head to the cheese area to buy our cheese there to make the best possible cheese fondue that we can have here in the country of the cheese fondue.
Okay, no, we're actually not gonna go to Emmental, we're gonna go to the town of Gruyère, because Gruyère apparently is the main ingredient, the main cheese in Swiss cheese fondue.
So it will be approximately a 2.5 hour round trip just to get some cheese. Are we genius? Are we crazy? I'm not sure. What do you guys think? arrived to cheesiness. The capital of cheese. Extreme cheesing.
Yeah, it is located in the French-speaking part of Switzerland. They have two official languages here, I guess. German and French and Swiss.
Swiss not really an official language.
It's like a crossover between German and...
I think they also have Italian and Roman language.
Anyway, loads of languages here. Bit where we just were, Grindelwald, where we recorded the previous video where we went to Grindelwald first in the Alps. That was the German-speaking part. Right now we're in one of the French-speaking cantons and I have no idea where the entrance to the cheese shop is.
It does feel smelly and does smell very cheesy in here.
Yeah.
I mean, kind of what you expect.
Oh, here it is, here it is. Eclair cheese.
I'll take this one. It looks fun.
Think it's big enough? Here is where they store the wheels, as they call them, the big blocks of cheese of Gruyère, right here. These wheels weigh 35 kilograms each. Depending on the season, between 4,000 and 7,000 wheels of Gruyère mature in the cellars at a temperature of 12 to 18 degrees Celsius at a very specific humidity of 92%.
Fondue pour deux personnes.
We have the cheese.
Pretty much everything we need. We have the cheese for the fondue.
Got some bread, got
some
meat.
Bread, some little bit of meat. So I think we're all set for our adventure.
Yeah. So we have found ourselves a nice spot to stay for the night. Right here in the mountains. Look at that view. It's still quite misty, so we didn't get a chance to go for the cheese fondue today, but the weather should be better tomorrow, so we're gonna try and go tomorrow.
Hi there!
Plan for the rest of the day?
Get some work done, because we still need to do loads of editing and other stuff. Always good fun, and I mean, could be worse.
It's cold outside, stick your hand outside.
My head or my hand?
Your hand.
Oh. Yeah, it is pretty cold.
That's not your hand. We'll see you guys in the morning for some cheese, we hope.
A couple of days later, because we had some winter storms, snow, a bit of everything.
Crappy
really
weather.
Conducive to cheese fondue outside. Inside is pretty good though, when you have a winter storm. Outside, not good at all.
But today, we have, what, can you see it? Behind me, all around, blue skies. And we're gonna do a cheese fondue at what we hope is a beautiful lakeside spot. Now you might not be able to see it, but you sure can hear the fondue.
We came prepared.
We came prepared. And now, inside the park,
beautiful.
It's a nice forested
this
area.
This park is called Blausee, which is German for
blue
lake.
Lake, yeah.
Which, I mean, most lakes are blue. Blue lake.
This one is said to be particularly blue. Alright, I think we have found pretty much the perfect spot.
Oh, yeah.
There's this barbecue.
Sun sign, barbecue eating area here.
And the view.
View.
Is not bad.
Wow. We came prepared. Well, kind of prepared, kind of unprepared, but
oh, no.
I'm a guy for that. So, pop. Gas stoved up. Cutting board. Bottle of white wine, essential. Cheese, also quite essential. Charcuterie. Utensils, garlic, spices, everything. Water. Thingy to mix. Coaster. I did forget the bread in the car though, which was a bit painful because it was long to get into the park, but
managed to multitask it.
I bought two good wines at the stand here where they're also selling food, and I asked the guy really nicely, can you sell me some bread? So I brought some cheese and I forgot the bread. He's like, oh no,
here you go. A national emergency.
He's like, no, just take the bread, it's okay. Now, for my secret cheese fondue recipe, if you tell this to anybody else, find you and track you down. I bought some Swiss white wine here from the Lavaux area, one of the most famous wines area here. This one came recommended for making cheese fondue. Now for the most important part, of course, the cheese. This recipe is the moitié-moitié, which is French for half-half. It's half Gruyère and half Vacherin. Also a very typical Swiss cheese. But yeah, quite essential step. Turn on the gas.
So now we just wait for the wine to heat up a little bit.
Yeah.
And then we introduce, slowly, gradually introduce the grated cheese.
Yeah, you need to use grated cheese and you need to put it in slowly and melt it slowly. Don't put it on high fire, cheese will separate. You'll have a cheese ball together with some fat.
It is actually quite cold. It's -9 or -10, but
it's -10 outside, but I mean,
when you're in the sun.
Cheese is making me hot. No, it's the sun, not the cheese too. Doesn't need a whole lot, but a pinch of pepper and a clove of garlic will go a long way. Oh.
Today is actually also Valentine's Day. It's a Sunday and it's Valentine's Day, which is why there are quite a lot of people around here.
Some wine for my lady. I'm just gonna put this back into the fridge.
Oh, it's such a beautiful spot though.
The weather is just perfect.
We had to wait for a while for a sunny day, but when the sun came, it made all the difference. Wine's pretty good. I've never had Swiss wine before, I think. It's quite good, actually.
Oh, the forks, wait. Put away the forks. Cue dramatic music.
Dun dun, du-du-du-dun, du-du-du-dun, du-du-du-du-dun. Oh, the cheesiness is perfect.
Almost dropped it. Oh, by the way, if you lose your piece of bread when you're dipping it in cheese, as a man, you need to buy the next round of drinks. I think traditionally, as a woman, you're supposed to kiss the person next to you.
That would be you, little Valentine.
Cheese. Oh, this is so good. Oh, this is so good. Cheesy, gooey, salty, nice and warm. It's cold outside. Oh.
All right. Just letting it simmer for a little bit longer. We do have to keep an eye on it. Because normally when you go to eat cheese fondue, it comes with this little stove that goes super, super slowly. But this one is actually our normal stove top. It's like, rah! It only has two modes, go and go really hard. So it's boiling again. Gonna take a little bit of the charcuterie. Look at the cheesiness. Look at the stringiness. It is perfect. And it smells amazing. It's really good.
Cheesegasm.
Cheesegasm.
All of this costs us about 28 Swiss francs. It's about 25 euros, 28 US dollars, which is, according to Swiss standards, fairly cheap, because if you want to eat cheese fondue, probably for two people you would be at 100 Swiss francs. With a bottle of wine, probably 130 Swiss francs or something. So all in all, it's fairly affordable to do it like this. I mean, it's $1 million view, so cannot complain.
It turns out that we're actually not that short on bread. I mean, we could have done with a little bit more, but we can also just eat the cheese fondue with the fork. Oh, string it along, By the way, this is not as uncommon in Switzerland as you would think, as I initially thought. The people right behind us are apparently having a little raclette. They're having a feast of their own.
Yeah, raclette is slightly different because just pieces of cheese you melt on a plate, but in the end.
It's more like grilling it instead of making like this stringy mixture of it.
Mm.
There are more condiments to go with it.
It's eating warm cheese.
It's about the cheese. It's about the cheese. And clogging,
Swiss are cheesy
clogging
people.
Your arteries with Swiss cheese.
Swiss are cheesy people. I do see a bunch of hungry Swiss people standing around here. So I'm not sure how much longer we'll be very safe here, because Swiss are like generally kind people, but.
You did a good job making it.
It's for my Valentine. Professionally scraping out the pot here. I am a professional cheese fondue eater, and I know the best bits can be found at the bottom because it's slightly crispified, slightly more flavor. Mm. And you may think this looks empty, but it's not. There's a whole world of hidden cheese out there. Now just stop filming so I can use my fingers to grab all the last cheese out. I want people to see this.
Oh, the sun is disappearing behind the mountain. You finished eating just in time.
Oh, perfect timing. What do you say? No filming.
Of course, we cannot forget to clean up after ourselves.
Best to do the clean up before the cheese coma hits. Time to do a bit of walking. For the it's already starting to set in, the cheese coma.
Oh yeah.
Starting to feel sluggish, a little bit sleepy, like I could use a nap together with some alcohol. Perfect combination for a nap.
Perfect combination for Valentine's Day.
Perfect. I can take what I need to get by. It doesn't make it easy. The other piece of my heart moves slow. Somewhere in the great unknown. When I return from the afterglow, will you carry me like I am whole again? Wait, hold on, put me together, take me back where I belong. I want it all. I had a feeling that the feeling.
Hi there, we're back in the van. We have officially entered cheese coma territory. We're gonna try to edit a little bit to get a new video out to you. And we're gonna leave you here. We're gonna see you again. I'm not gonna say where, because it will depend on the weather, but I think it's gonna be, next video is gonna be really nice when you're gonna like it. So if you enjoyed this video, please smash that like button, subscribe if you wanna follow along on the rest of our Switzerland journey and beyond, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.